Well, thank you so much. It's really a honor, Susan, to be here with all of you today and your team at Health Affairs for the hard work that I'm aware of that you've put into making this publication successful. I also want to recognize the issue advisor, Jaime Sepulveda, professor and director of the Global AIDS Programs, the Global Health Programs at UC San Francisco, for really guiding the development of the issue. Having served as the chair of the first IOM report evaluation of PEPFAR, he really was a perfect choice. And special thanks go out to our congressional colleagues, Congress represented here today by Congressman Jim McDermott, truly a hero and fighter in this arena for so many years, and now serves as the co-chair of the HIV/AIDS Caucus. I also want to recognize the Hill staff who are here or watching the webcast. Without the support of Congress, we are very clear that we would not be able to do the work that we do here. And speaking for those who benefit from the services that are created in the countries in which we work, we are grateful to you for that. It's also a pleasure I don't know if Agnes Binaguahu is here this morning.
She was not able to come.
Okay, well, I will in absentia acknowledge Agnes as really an extraordinary partner and friend for her work in her country and for her aggressive move toward country ownership. I appreciate the participation of our business leaders, Jeffrey May and Renuka from Merck and BD. Thanks also to our partners from PEPFAR's implementing agencies, including my colleague, Ambassador Nils Dallaire from HHS. I'd also like to thank the authors of the manuscripts for your thoughtful contributions to PEPFAR's development, to concretize where we've been, to reflect on the appropriateness of our footprint programmatically, and to look to the future to think about where we need to go. I want to thank you sincerely for approaching this effort in the spirit of helping us to do our work better and to save more lives. Most of all, I'd like to salute the contribution of the people who make this work happen in the field. For all of us who work here at home, whether in the government, the private sector, or NGOs, our role is to support our partner countries in saving lives. So what we really do today, in a very real sense, is reflect and tell their story. The healthcare providers, faith-based organizations, and community groups, the businesses, the people living with HIV, they are the hands and feet who have led the transformation over the past decade. It's thanks to them that the PEPFAR program was able to make incredible progress in both a programmatic impact, but just as importantly, in returning and expanding hope to the communities in which we work. You'll be hearing from many people today, so I'm going to make my comments short. I'd like to start by highlighting the unique opportunity that PEPFAR has provided us, which this special issue does capture in a very direct way. In simple terms, PEPFAR has given us a chance to take new science, newly understood, put it to work in the field rapidly, and move it to scale. Once moved to scale, we have the ability to look at what we've done, to evaluate it, to analyze it, and to feed that information, that understanding, back into how our programs interface or don't interface with the populations we are concerned with, do or do not retain people in care over time, and respond to the evolving needs of people with HIV and HIV-TB. All of this is taken within an incredibly accelerated time frame. I'm not aware of anything else in the global health space that has been able to really telescope these different elements with the combination and speed that we have seen with the PEPFAR Global Fund presence. It's as close to a real feedback loop as we've had. It is one of the, I think, distinguishing features of how PEPFAR operates, in that it truly is an organization that learns from what it's doing and makes every attempt to reintegrate the lessons back into the program in the future. The manuscripts you'll be discussing today are part of this healthy process of discussion and analysis, and as a learning organization, we are grateful for them. The world is learning so much from this experience that wouldn't happen without this country's investment and commitment to do the work on a large scale. Without that, we'd still be stuck doing small-scale pilot projects and still be asking ourselves whether it's really possible to change the dynamic of AIDS. So many of you in this room came out of that space. But that question has been asked, and it has been answered. As we continue to expand our impact on AIDS, we face a related need to make the best use of the PEPFAR platforms we've established to address the range of global health challenges. We can't lose sight of the big picture PEPFAR. Many in this room remember just how desperate the situation was not so long ago, less than a decade ago. The hopelessness was overwhelming. But despite the complexities of AIDS as a disease to diagnose and to treat, the United States took it on with a targeted approach on a large scale and with accountability for results. This group knows the impact it's had, though I would note that many others still don't, so it's important that we get the word out. Yet what even many experts don't appreciate is the broader transformational impact of this work on the health sector. We are beginning to see it, and more importantly, we are beginning to document it. The hospitals and clinics, the health workers, the labs, the supply chains, all these focused investments have strengthened national systems to meet the whole range of health needs. And that helps us understand the improvements we've seen in non-HIV indicators, such as maternal, child, and TB-related mortality, use of antenatal care, and safe blood supply. I believe we've just scratched the surface of what can be achieved on these platforms. To place additional services on top of an existing platform is not only smart and cost-effective, but it is responding to the needs of the people we serve. And I note we've done this without compromising our impact on HIV. We are looking at that very closely in every setting we're in. In fact, we've done it even as we've steadily increased our HIV results 2-3 times where they were. It's not either or, but they really do go hand in hand in our thinking. The papers you hear about today will tell this story, challenge us to ask how do we build on this benefit to the broader issues of health. And I believe PEPFAR has raised the bar for all of us. Well, we're not doing any of this alone, nor should we. In PEPFAR's second phase, we've prioritized support for country ownership, as Secretary Clinton described in her Oslo speech last month, and what it will take to make this effort a sustainable fixture of the landscape in each country as it needs to be. Congress gave us partnership frameworks in the 2008 reauthorization as a tool to advance country ownership, joint roadmaps on AIDS that we enter into with partner governments. These have made it possible for us to plan collaboratively with them on how to build their capacity. They've built trust as we've had to reveal vulnerabilities and get real and focused on responding to them in a partnership, a collegial partnership. These frameworks have also given us a forum in which to highlight policy or other issues that may be holding countries back, whether it's failure to focus on key populations at highest risk, lack of inclusion of women, or not collaborating with the faith sector that does so much of the work. Of course, another recurring barrier is inadequate investment in health from national budgets. We have, through the partnership framework, been able in each country to have that difficult conversation and hold both our colleagues in country and ourselves responsible to deliver and expand and exceed those expectations. If we look only at our efforts and those of countries, we overlook the essential role of the multilateral sector, the third leg of the stool, you might say. I think by the end of AIDS 2012, the world may be a bit tired of hearing us use the phrase shared responsibility, but that's okay. We'll keep saying it because it's where we need to be, it's what we need to do better, and it's what will allow us to expand our programmatic footprints. We continue to see the Global Fund as a good investment for the United States. Each dollar we invest leverages funds from other donors that do not, and never will, have big bilateral programs like PEPFAR. When it works right, the fund brings those resources from many directions to bear on unmet needs identified by countries, and it achieves major health impact. Our confidence that the Global Fund will work right and that its resources will be used effectively and efficiently is growing each day as it implements its reform agenda and comes to see itself as an active investor. The United States has been supporting this evolution at every step. I'm deeply encouraged to see these changes take root in a deep way. The success of the two programs is inextricably linked. We are bound together. Together we will have more impact, and we will expand our impact more efficiently in the settings we are in. PEPFAR and the Global Fund are expanding our joint planning at the country level, but more importantly, we are doing it under the oversight of the country. Supporting country ownership means helping them to develop their capacity to lead and direct external partners, to manage and oversee these programs, to monitor and evaluate them. Let me close here. These next few weeks as we move into AIDS 2012 are important ones for the future, not only of PEPFAR and HIV, but of the larger global health effort. At a time when money remains tight and will be for the foreseeable future, people want to know if we can actually have an AIDS-free generation. You play a critical role in assuring them that we can. Even with constrained resources for a number of years now, we have continued to substantially increase our results, which is the true test of success. The papers in this issue of Health Affairs help make that case. The more people that see this information, I believe, the more convinced they'll be that an AIDS-free generation is something that we not only can achieve, but we must achieve. I want to thank you. It is truly an honor for me to continue to walk down this road together as we broaden our impact with both PEPFAR programs and our integration into country systems of care. It's an exciting moment. I want to thank you for your perseverance and your dedication as we move to getting across that finish line. So it's been a real honor. Thank you.